Do you want to set parental controls on your browser? Well, in this video, we will look at some easy steps you can take to ensure your child has a safe web experience. For more information on the topic, be sure to check out the article in the description. First, let's look at ways to do it in on your system if you have more than one browser on your system. If you want to try and update the host files, we did a video on how to adjust your host files and we'll include a link to it. But in a nutshell, open Explorer, go to /Windows/System32/Drivers/etc and hit enter. Right click on the host file, select to open it with the notepad, click OK, go down to 127.0.0.1 and change that with blocksite.com. Save it, then restart your system. Let's look at Chrome. The easiest way to set parental control in Chrome is by using extensions. These browser extensions go a long way to cover up for a browser's shortfall. Most of these extensions come with sophisticated features such as a profanity filter, warnings, blacklisting, whitelisting, or outright blocking content. You can search the Chrome store for the best extension for you. The article we link has three good options for you to choose from. I decided to go with Website Blocker. Click on Add to Chrome. Then go in and make any changes that you want to customize it to your personal needs. If we want to set controls in Edge, unlike Chrome, Microsoft Edge is equipped with lots of parental control settings. Edge works with Microsoft Defender Smart Screen to identify malware and phishing websites. It does this by showing you warnings whenever you wish to visit these pages or are about to download content from them. Smart Screen isn't specifically developed as a parental control feature, but it goes a long way to serve the purpose. To enable Smart Screen in Edge, click on Settings, then go to Privacy Search and Services. Make sure that Microsoft Defender Smart Screen is on. Firefox, like Chrome, offers extensions you can download and add to block adult content. In the article, we go over some of them you can use. I decided to install Fox Filter. Just click on Add to Firefox and follow any of the prompts to install. It has a free version, but if you want advanced settings, you'll need to buy the premium edition. Click on Continue to add in subscriptions and follow any of the on-screen prompts. If you want to disable password saving in Firefox, you'll just go to Options, go to Settings, Privacy and Security. Then you'll find the option to ask to save logins and passwords for websites. Uncheck this option to disable password saving on the browser and prevent your kids from using your logins to access content that they shouldn't be seeing. Then, let's look at Opera. Like Chrome and Firefox, it requires an extension to set parental controls. Once again, we link to some Opera extensions in the article. I decided to try Disconnect. Now, this one was not developed specifically for parental control, but it is helpful in preventing access to websites and tracking your internet activity. Just click on Protect Yourself and follow any of the on-screen prompts. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.